significant figures. Every number has a few digits which are significant and few which are not significant. So we are going to see the rules for what makes certain digits in a number significant and certain not significant. So the first rule is that all non-zero digits are significant. So if the number is not a zero, it's significant. So over here, 1 is significant, 5 is significant, both these ones are significant. What is the rule about 0? All interior zeros are significant, all trailing zeros are significant, trailing zeros that fall before a decimal point are significant. The only thing that's not significant is going to be leading zeros are not significant. So over here we have 0.005. None of these zeros are significant. So besides this, all other zeros are significant. So over here, when it talks about interior zeros, 4.0208, both these zeros are significant because they are interior zeros. 50.1, this zero is significant. Trailing zeros that fall after decimal point, so 5.10, 3.00, they are both significant. Trailing zeros that fall before a decimal point are significant. So anything before a decimal point is significant. What is not significant? If it is a number like 0.00005102. If you have a number like this, the significant figures or the significant digits is going to be this 5, 1, and 0. None of the zeros in front are significant. So this is only going to have 4 significant figures. So significant figures, they sometimes are also called sig figs, which means significant figures. We see a lot of numbers which are ambiguous, which is the 6th category over here. So the 6th category is trailing zeros at the end of a number, but before an implied decimal point are ambiguous and should be avoided. So 350 cars. So we don't know what it is. You could write it as 3.50. In this case, we have 2 sig figs because exponents 10 raised to any number is not important. 3.50, we have 3 sig figs over here. So if there is no decimal point, it's usually ambiguous. We have another category on its own, which is called exact numbers. Exact numbers have unlimited sig figs. A good example of it is pi. So most of us know pi is equal to 3.14. And we use that in calculation to find what's the radius of the circle and so on. But in reality, it actually goes on and on and on and on to infinity. So in the same way, when you have any conversions, for example, you know, 1 pound is equal to so many ounces, or so many yards make an inch. So all those numbers, they're exact numbers, which means that they actually keep going on till infinity. So if you have numbers like that, we say they're exact numbers and we don't actually talk about sig figs in those. So let's go ahead and do an exercise over here. How many sig figs are present in all of these numbers? So pause this video and solve this question. So in A, you have 2 sig figs because the zeros in front are not important. They are leading zeros. In the second one, all of them are sig figs. Now, question number 3 is actually ambiguous. There is no decimal point. So I'm just going to write ambiguous. Over here, we have 3 sig figs for D. 1 dozen is equal to 12. This is a relationship, a ratio similar to pi is equal to 3.14. So this is going to be ambiguous. I'm sorry, this is going to be exact number. 100.00. So the zeros, the trailing zeros are significant. So this is going to have 5 sig figs. And finally, the last one, again, there is no decimal point. Some of you may write it as 1.0 times 10 raised to 3, 4, 5. Some of you may write it as 1.000 times 10 raised to 5. So we are not sure if those zeros are significant or not. So this is going to be ambiguous number. So let's do a review. Express the following numbers in scientific notation. So in the first one, we're actually not sure because there is no decimal, if it's important or not. I'm just going to make an assumption that there's a decimal over here. So in that case, we will go ahead and write it as 4.5000. If there was a decimal here, how many sig figs are present in it? All of them are significant. So when we are writing it in scientific notation, we have to include all of them. So this is going to be times 10 raised to 3. This is going to be 4.5 times 10 raised to negative 2. How many sig figs does this have? 2. This has 5. So when we are writing the scientific notation, if those zeros are important, they have to be included. This has 2 and this has 2 sig figs also. So the last one is going to be 4.5 times 10 raised to 1, 2, 3, 4, negative 4. So we are now going to look at rounding. So the rules we're going to follow for rounding are round down if the last digit is 4 or less. Round up if the last digit dropped is 5 or more. So this should be a review for most of you. So for these numbers, if you have to round them to 2 sig figs, what are you going to do? So we look at the digit right after 2. This is 3. 3 is less than 4. So this is going to remain as 2.3. Over here, 7 is greater than 4. So this is going to be 2.4. The 3 in this case goes and becomes 4. So 2.4. We round it up. We do not round it over here. We do not round it here. We do round it here. 2.4. So that is how rounding up and down works. So let's go to sig figs in calculation, multiplication, and division. So you need to have your calculators out for this part. So the rule for multiplication or division, so we have a separate rule for addition and subtraction. So for multiplication and division, the rule is the final answer should have the same number of sig figs as the factor with the lowest sig figs. So that means we have to count how many sig figs are present. So over here we have 3 sig figs. Over here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sig figs. And over here we have 2 sig figs. This means once you do the calculation on your calculator, your final answer should have 2 sig figs, because comparing all of these 3 numbers, the least sig figs is what your answer should have. So this is what you should get as your answer. And because we can only have 2 digits, we look at the next digit to decide if we round it up or down. Because this is 0, we do not round up. We leave it as 45. So over here, there's a division problem. Same rule. 3 sig figs here and 4 sig figs here. Final answer should have 3 sig figs. So this is our answer over here. So 1, 2, 3. So we look at 5 and look at the number after that to decide if it gets rounded up or down. So this ends up becoming 0.966 as the next number is 9. Let's look at the sig fig rules for addition and subtraction. So the rule is a little different. The rule in this case is that the answer should have the same sig fig as the quantity with the fewest decimal points. So what that means is look at all the numbers and see which one has the least number of decimal points. Over here, we have 1 digit after decimal point, 2 digits after decimal point, and 2 digits after decimal point. So our final answer should have 1 digit after decimal point. So add all of these 3 numbers up, This is what you get as the answer. We should only have one digit after decimal point. So the number after 0 is 5. We round up, which is how we get it as 671.1. Over here again, we have 3 sig figs over here, 3 here, and 4 here. But we're not looking at sig figs, are we? We are looking at the digits after decimal point. So we have 2 over here, 3 over here, and 3 here. So final answer should have 2 digits after decimal point. So when you subtract it out, we get the answer as 9.21. This is a subtraction, so we look at the digits after decimal point, 1 digit over here and 3 digits over here. So final answer should have 1 digit after decimal point. So these are the rules for sig figs in calculations. So these are a few example problems. Go ahead and solve them and see if this is what you're getting as the answers.